Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is Deepa Madhav. Today we are going to talk about FOMO. What is FOMO? Fear of missing out is a social anxiety stemmed from the belief that others might be having fun while the person experiencing the anxiety is not present. It is characterized by a desire to stay continually connected with what others are doing. This is according to Wikipedia. So in simple terms, fear of missing out means you have a fear or you're unhappy that you're missing out something while attending to another thing. Let's understand that we cannot be present everywhere, every time. If you are experiencing a joy at one place, then you need to forego another joy at another place. So that's FOMO. But a human mentality is such that in today's world, there are n number of things to enjoy, to relish ourselves, and if you're not able to fulfill any of that desire, then your mind starts to feel sad about the fear that you are going to miss out huge. We know that this is not possible, that you cannot be present everywhere, but still that feeling of sadness is always there in us. So how do we overcome that? How do we tackle that? There are few techniques which might help you in order to overcome this FOMO factor. And let me help you with few things. First one is doing one thing at a time. Doing one thing at a time is something like we try to multitask too many things at a time, hoping that we get happiness out of every task that we do. But to talk in real terms, that is highly impossible. Instead of focusing on too many things and trying to find happiness in each and everything, focus only one task at a time. What happens is, if you focus on one task at a time, the quality of the task will definitely improve. And the happiness what you get out of it is more compared to multitasking and trying to find happiness in all the tasks. So try to focus only one task at a time. Be in the present. Be in the present situation wherever you are in. If, for example, if you are in Delhi enjoying your friend's wedding and at the same time there is an office party in Goa, is it possible for you to go to both the places? So, for example, you are attending the Delhi wedding, then you should enjoy the wedding totally with your friends. Absolute enjoyment. Do not think about the party which is in Goa. Just delete it. Or if possible, don't see the pics, any of the pics your office members are sending. Don't see the pics, don't think about the Goa office party. If you are present in in your friend's wedding, enjoy your friend's wedding. And that's it. Do not think beyond that. Yoga and meditation. If you observe in all my mind being or my wellness videos, I would have stressed every video about yoga and meditation. There is not a single video where I haven't talked about yoga and meditation, because any health issues or any physical issues you come across, the only answer I find in my research is yoga and meditation. So yoga and meditation is a cure for all your mental well-being as well as physical well-being. Practice mindfulness. What is mindfulness? First thing you have to do is spend some time in the mornings to yourself. The minute you wake up, you don't have to rush outside and attend to other person's needs. Just give some time to yourself. Wake up from the bed, sit and enjoy the morning. Thank God for giving you another beautiful day. Process everything in your mind. Feel yourself. Appreciate the nature. You can go outside, see the birds chirping, see the flowers blooming. Try to appreciate nature. Sit into the nature. Meditate. Meditate when you enjoy the nature. Meditate when you are at home. I understand there are a lot of fast foods nowadays. But why don't you cook a meal at home with adding all the enjoyable flavors that you like, colors that you like, and make a decent and nice meal. eat slowly, enjoy what you eat, relish what you eat, observe the taste. That is practicing mindfulness. Create something. And that's why people from olden days have stressed on hobbies and creativity. When you create something out of your own, and whatever it may be, it might turn good, it might turn bad, but end of the day, you're trying to create something instead of taking what is already existing. That is practicing mindfulness. Next technique, accept that you cannot do everything. We are humans, even gods sometimes cannot do everything. Then why we humans justify ourselves, find fault with ourselves, thinking that, oh, I am not able to do this. No, I am not able to do that. It's okay. Our needs are limited. Our wants are limited. Understand that. And just focus on how much ever you can do. Don't try to jump in all the places and get sad about not being able to do some of the things. Accept the opportunity cost. What is opportunity cost? If you are attending Delhi's friend's wedding, accept that you will not be able to attend your office party in Goa. If you are going and attending an office party in Goa, accept the fact that you are giving up your friend's wedding in order to enjoy at the office party. But being in one place and suffering for the place that you have not been there, that's going to create FOMO, which I'm sure you don't want. Take deep breaths. Whenever you feel that you're missing out something, take deep breaths, which will control your emotions and bring back to normalcy. Declutter your mind and space. There is so much of unwanted things in your mind as well as space around your house. Try to find them, declutter them. If you see them, then you will feel you want more and more. But if you start decluttering and have a minimal of your space, then you won't feel that you're missing out something. Avoid social websites. I understand social websites will be for a lot of people, it's overwhelming. You see your friends or your relatives or anybody outside having a ball of their life. But in reality, they are just showing their glooming side, the bright side of their life. The darker side of the life, nobody wants to put it in social websites. So let's not get carried away with whatever we find on social media. It just shows the pluses of life, never shows the minuses of life. You can, but to a limited extent. If you can't handle that, then please do not look into social websites. Take more fun activities wherever you can create fun, like playing games, indoor games, outdoor games. Anywhere where you can have some fun, go for that. Be around with positive friends. Whenever you pick up a friend, make sure that they talk positive, they behave positive. We don't want negative people around us, because these negative people will make your mind even more disturbing. So at the maximum, try to be around with positive friends. Stop comparing yourself. Why do we need to compare ourselves? We have our life. We know our limitations. We know our plus. We know our minus. Our lives are different from other person's life. So whatever you have, you know what you have, what you don't have. Don't compare yourself with others. Compare yourself with yourself. Like how I am today, how I was yesterday, and how I'm going to be tomorrow. So just stop comparing yourself. So these are some of the techniques that I found in my research about FOMO, how to overcome that. And in fact, I've started practicing them wholeheartedly. And I already could feel a lot of difference. And I hope that you will also benefit from some of these points. I know these points are already existing. Many of you would know. But if you find it helpful, I'm sure it will benefit you in a long way. Thanks for your time. I hope you like this video. If you find it interesting, do click on the like button. Do subscribe to my channel for many upcoming interesting videos. Thank you.